Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu Planescape Torment und Revel Puzzle Well. Wir machen mit unserem Gespräch weiter. I'm through answering your questions, Revel. Now you'll answer mine. Of course. Ever questions? Ever questions. Why did you make me immortal, Revel? It's what you wanted, seedling, and you ask so sweetly. Now, how could Revel say no to one such as you? Immortality was your solution and your challenge to me. My solution? But why? I don't know, seedling. Time is chipped away at my memories as well, it would seem. Seem? If you remember, tell me. I'm curious myself. It must have been something important. Isn't it in the nature of a man to want to live forever? Only if that lies on the other path carries greater pain. Only if what lies on the other path carries greater pain. Revel, this is very important. Do you have any idea why I ask you to do it?
Death was a thing you needed to dodge. An easy thing to say, mayhap, but to do it is not. Immortality, even with its flaws, was the best solution this withered mind could untangle. Yet, lead is not easily changed to gold, but it is impossible. Through the unwise, Revel, if water can be drawn from blood, mortality can be taken from a mortal, peeled back like a sticky film.
So you pulled it off.
The gulf between man and unman is great. You traveled the distance. I provided the means, but you crossed on your own.
Revel slaps her head and rakes her into her hair.
Bad, Revel. Mortals are too flawed to be made to last. Still they break. They must be dragged kicking and screaming into an unhealthy new mold.
Unhealthy? So the ritual was flawed.
Shortcuts must be made, and they can break the molded. For it is not always the mold that breaks, but the substance poured within it. Force something into a shape it was not meant to be, and it breaks. I thought the material was of stronger stuff, but you have been broken.
But I am immortal. Surely that was a success.
You have survived long, immortal one, but you have become the prey of the creatures that... you have become the prey of the creature that is life.
She cups her hands, then reverses it, forming a canopy with her hands.
The body is but a hut for the soul, but now no one dwells in that hut.
What went wrong with the ritual?
Puzzle-fleshed, broken, beautiful, beautiful mortal man, the ritual was not a finished thing.
Revel's brows wrinkle, and her talons pick at her hair, tugging on a lone strand.
The ritual gave you what you wanted, but...
But?
The ritual gave you what you wanted, but great were the costs. The casting of shadows, the quiet, violent death of the mind, and the pain-taking emptiness. These things are dangerous are in such a fragile vessel, no matter how strong a mortal man. Regret them, and the rituals do I.
Casting of shadows?
Ungrateful shades. But ungrateful without cause? The shades, they hate you, nameless one, for they are fathered by you. Your children, once forsaken, they will never forgive. They will do everything they can to destroy the parent, such is the way of children.
How do I father shades, these shadows?
Thank you.
This was slightly disturbing.
You cast shadows on existence, nameless one. With every death, a shadow arises fresh from the fields of your flesh. They wander for a time, but always they return, looking to murder their parent. Such is the way of many offspring.
Weather purses her lips in disapproval, then suddenly pokes you in the chest with a talon.
And thankless young men such as yourself.
Tell me more about this ritual. The quiet, violent death of the mind?
A thousand deaths and you recover from each. Not so the mind. The mind is much more fragile. Its scars run deep and do not heal. The brain is encased in a hard bone shell, difficult to breach, but with no defense against that which eats at it from within.
Pain-taking emptiness?
You have a hole where your mortality once lay within your shell.
She makes a hand into a fist and shakes it.
Rattle, rattle, goes the hollow man, a baby's plaything with naught but a tiny stone that clatters and clacks in your frame.
Despite these problems, it seems like the ritual worked.
Updated my journal.
Do you doubt, Revel? Of course I delivered on what was promised. Not long after the spell drew too close, I killed you to see if it had worked. You struggled so, but I kept my grip tight and watched you die your first of many deaths. Then was I learned in its flaws.
What flaws?
Ego unwraps us like a prison. Forgot I did that...
Forgot I did that, it oftentimes serves as... Forgot I did? Mein Gott, spricht wie Yoda.
Forgot I did that, it oftentimes serves as a shield.
Ever clicks the tongue.
My pretty, pretty thing. There's much wisdom and understanding in the truth that life is preparation for the ultimate goal, death. Our life is a means by which we learn how to die. If we forget such things...
So that's when you discovered I lost my memories when I died.
Yes. Unfortunate. Without the mortality to hold such memories tight, the shell the body is...
So you took my mortality from me. Is it still intact? Revel seems surprised, then alarmed.
Yes, yes, yes! Fear not for a broken mortality. If you are here, talking to me... At me, intact your mortality must be. Such a thing cannot not be destroyed as long as you exist. You are an anchor of your mortal soul. As long as you are intact, so shall it be. Made to last are you.
Revel smiles and gives a wheezing laugh.
For life swallowed you and spit you out.
It swallowed him, but I don't know if he came out of that and danke, Mord, das... War das nötig? Wirklich? Enough of this. Look, Revel, you took my mortality from me, and it has caused more harm than good. I would take it back now. You have had it over long, I think. Yeah.
Ah, you make a demand.
Revel's black-veined eyes sharpen and twist, taking a disturbing awareness, and she bares her yellow fangs.
No. That, Revel, I will not do. What is undone cannot be done.
Why not?
Revel cannot give such a thing to you, my precious man, for Revel has nothing to give. I never possessed you or your mortality. Though I wish to keep them both in my garden as selfish affections, keepsakes, trace the patterns of your flesh, but such things Revel could not bring herself to do.
Why not?
You loved him!
Anna breaks the silence. She sounds astonished. You loved him, you did!
Revel gives a low, white smile. Is that so hard for you to believe, fiendling?
She cackled softly to herself.
Does Revel, being Revel, and thus a myth, not deserve to carry such a feeling in her black brambled heart?
No creature is undeserving of such a feeling, Revel. The histories do not paint such a compassionate picture of you, however.
The past is past, and histories care little for speaking the truth of it.
Revel frowns, then her voice drops slightly, threateningly, as she studies Grace.
The feeling brushed me, yes. And now hold your silver tongue, Abyssal daughter. I need not your soft words to cloud the air here. The man and I shall speak, and you shall bow out of this. I shall attend to you shortly.
Enough, Revel. If you don't have my mortality, where is it?
I don't know, sweet thing. But if I were you, I'd get it back quick. No telling what horrible things someone could do if they held your mortality for a ransom.
Revel clicks her talons together.
It would like be holding someone's sweet, succulent soul. A puppet dancing on someone's strength, would you be? And a most sad puppet, too. Too? Know where it is? I do not.
Hold a moment. You say you don't know where my mortality is. Do you know someone who does know where it is? Revel smiles horridly, her tusks gleaming.
Clever, clever, clever you are, yes. There's another who might know the things that Revel does not.
Another may know. Who? Revel's eyes dim, as if she is staring at something in the distance, and her voice slows.
A fair-skinned one, must you ask? An angel, a diva. One who soars on the wings of morning and with his hands is the architect of horizons. He lies beyond...
What? He lies beyond my keeping, in another cage, in another prison. In his knowing is the knowing of what you wish to know.
Ask him your questions, listen to his answers, use them as guides.
Where can I find this angel?
Updated my journal.
In leaving this prison to another cursed prison will you arrive. Though it may not appear such to casual glances, step lightly and find the gold link in the ever-shortening chain. The light shall give the dark of the matter, and new paths shall open to you.
I had some other questions. I have some questions about you, Revel.
Yes, ask your questions about Revel, my precious man.
Revel, who are you? Where did you come from? Fangal Amadan.
I? Revel am I, a maker and breaker of puzzles, a solver of what cannot be solved, a mind reveling and unraveling until the threads of thought are tied up like knots in a drunken man's hair.
Revel picks at one of her jagged grey hairs, wrapping it around her finger.
It is enough it is.
But what are you? Some have called you a night hag, whatever that is.
Night hag?
Revel gives a ghastly smile, her yellow teeth like needles.
I am but a woman who is sorely missed her beloved creation. Some have named me Crone, Grey Lady, Yaga Sister, Night Hag. But myself is my name, Revel. Revel who puzzles well, providing conundrums to decipher and laying impossibilities low. But... Many things are said about we grey ladies. Ways are we night hags, but an individual am I. Some call us evil of old, stalkers of mortal dreams, the kindly ones, ugly, hideous things whose homes lie in the dark places of men's minds.
Revel's eyes narrow to reddish sparks. But that means nothing to me. What would one such as you call one such as I, pretty thing? Oh Gott, schon wieder. Ist auch ein bisschen Fishing for Compliments, ne? Das kann man nicht anders sagen. I would call you beautiful. Wir haben schon, diesbezüglich haben wir schon die ganze Zeit gelogen. Machen wir einfach weiter. Revel is silent for a moment, then she cackles.
Oh, you're a diamond, my precious songbird. You make the centuries worthwhile. How sweetly you sing to these tired ears that have feasted only on silence and the slow creep of black barbs spreading. Yet you lie to me.
No, Revel, I do not.
Do you think I care for truth? Deceit is beautiful to me, songbird, and Revel loves to hear you say such things. She does. Ugly I may be.
Revel, you are not ugly.
Yet ugly I need not be, pretty thing. My shape is but water to my will, and I may reweave its fibers to a more pleasing tapestry.
Revel glances at Foy from Grace, then smiles and licks her lips.
Yes.
Revel, what...
Experience has increased my skills.
What the fuck? Revel has melted into Foy from Grace, taking on her demeanor, her features, her clothes.
Is this shape more pleasing?
Revel smiles, her teeth now a brilliant, perfect white, the lips with just a hint of red.
So cultured and breathtaking?
She motions you to come closer.
Come, my precious man, my lips do not burn with abyssal torments. Lay your lips upon mine.
No, Revel.
Mayhap, is it the rougher woman that you crave, the one of passionate fire?
Revel glances at Anna, who stiffens as Revel's gaze pins her.
Mayhap it is her that whets your appetite.
Wait, see what happens. Ah, ja, gut, das war irgendwie zu erwarten. Revel has melted into Anna's shape, taking on her demeanor, her features, her leather vest.
Is this the rough-edged woman that you crave, the one for whom age has not yet tempered her passions?
Anna's Revel's tail flicks, as if in anticipation. Come and carry. Naja, eigentlich. Das ist Anna und. Ach, küssen wir sie einfach mal. You touch your lips to Revel's. Despite her new form, her lips are dry like sand, and as your lips touch, you feel a sharp pinprick, like kissing a row of barbed seeds. Hättest du ein bisschen bessere Illusion erschaffen können, Revel. You draw back, licking the blood from your lips. Revel mirrors your gesture, made even more horrifying in her new form. Ja, das glaube ich. A drop of your blood remains on the edge of her mouth, and she smiles evilly.
You bit me. And you bit me so long ago. 'Twas not a kiss then, but a bite to the heart.
Revel smiles.
Do not be surprised, my precious man. There's no harm done. Except, mayhap, to the ones you travel with.
She chuckles lightly and you suddenly become aware of Anna's gaze upon you. Her eyes are wide and her heart is beating rapidly. Grace, on the other hand, is watching Anna with a curious expression. Ja, sorry. Also, ich weiß, Grace, es passiert dir nicht oft, dass eine andere Frau dir vorgezogen wird, ne? Ist mir schon klar. Aber ist vielleicht eine neue Erfahrung. Ist als Sensei doch bestimmt ganz interessant. Resume your normal shape, Revel. Dankeschön. You blink and Revel has twisted back into her original form.
A difficult man to please, are you?
Pah! And wonder do they why there are no males of your kind.
What other shapes can you have you turned yourself into?
Maybe some, maybe none.
Revel seems confused by the question.
I have not remembered such. I've been mayhap. Neither smarter nor martyr. So many threads and branchings, so many revels. Always stitching and mending and growing are my forms.
Okay, das ist ja schon mal eine ganz interessante Information.
Mabeth, you were Mabeth? That may have been one of my names, yes.
Revel looks more confused, her black-winged eyes becoming misty.
Names are difficult to remember,
her voice becomes faint, like calling across a great distance.
Mabeth was kind to me and helped me, Revel. That means you helped me.
I thank you. As you mentioned, Mabeth, all the color seems to bleed out of Revel's face until she is gray and ashen. Literally. It's like the color just vanished.
And who might you be, Does your path bring you back to old Mabeth Dor, child?
Yes, it does, Mabeth. I came to learn more of the art. Can you teach me any more?
I'm but a midwife, child. Such powers as the art commands is much beyond me.
I don't think so. I think you may have more to teach me than you may realize. Much more. Then comes the question like an echo.
You want to learn the art, you do? Why do you want to learn such things?
Because I need power.
Pah! An ill desire, for the letter of the art will always remind you that there's another rung just above you. And there's a bunch of people and things that'll be on it too. There's always be someone better, and they'll learn ye if ye crave too much.
She leans in close. But if ye'd know, then listen.
Listen. Updated my journal.
Nice. Mabeth Revel whispered something and you feel different. Changed somehow. She told you something horrible, something about how the planes work, but your mind has shut out her words and you cannot recall them. Okay. Just thinking about them sets your heart pounding. Revel told you something you are not sure anyone was ever meant to know. She is watching you, studying you. What other shapes have you been, Revel?
You were Iveen?
In the mortuary?
Names are difficult.
In her own way, Iveen helped me, Revel. That means you helped me. I thank you. Das funktioniert, hat ja ganz gut funktioniert. Almost unconsciously, Revel's hand reaches out for you, and just for a moment you swear they are Iveen's talents. Stand your ground. Revel's left hand plucks a hair from her head, hooks it around her talons, and lightning-like, she jabs another talon into the skin near one of your scars. It's barely more than a pinprick, but it looks like she's about to start stitching you up mit ihren Haaren. Let her work.
Updated my journal.
Level up, oh Gottes Willen. As it was with Iveen, this sensation is curiously painless, but the thread and stitching seems to be going much deeper, almost inside you.
without actually going beyond the surface of the skin. In moments, Revel's talons draw back and you feel better, stronger. Revel mutters in Alvin's voice,
"Dumb Somfy."
"What other shapes have you been?" "You were that balmy seamstress in the buried village, Martha?" "Martha was balmy, Revel, but she was not unkind and not unhelpful. If you were her, then you mean me no harm. I thank you." As you say her name, Revel's face seems to shift. Her blue skin sags until she's wearing the same sour, curt-faced expression you saw on Martha's face. "Come on now, don't be all difficult on Martha." She raises the talon of her index finger like a scalpel and advances upon you.
"False, nasty cops."
"Stand your ground." Revel's filthy talon jabs into your abdomen, then pulls it brutally downwards in a saw-like motion. "Don't try this at home, kids." "But there is no pain."
Alles Lüge.
You watch as your skin peels slowly back from her touch. No blood issues from the wound. "Look at this, Martha. Look at this." "Let her work." Revel's free hand digs into your chest, where she loops your intestines up like yarn and plucks them from your stomach.
Ja, gut, dass ich noch nicht gegessen habe.
As she does, your stomach seals up as if time was going backwards. Martha, Revel, holds up your intestines like a trophy.
"Pretty, pretty, eh, Martha? One shouldn't swallow such a thing, no, no."
"Can I have those back, please? I might need them later." She hands you the ropey mass. Despite the freshness, the fluids surrounding your intestines have dried like resin. It feels more like a loop of glazed rope. "Thanks. I treasure this always." "I treasure this always, yo."
"Updated my journal."
"Martha, Revel." Not slowly.
"Yes, well, he should, shouldn't he, Martha?" "Yes, yes, he should, Martha. Powerful magic to be found in the guts of an immortal." "Yes, not like Tiki's or eyes."
"What other shapes have you been, Revel?" Okay. Other questions. "Why were you imprisoned, Revel?" Ask more, what is this place? Revel gestures around her.
"Once a maze of lifeless stone it was, featureless, but a small black seed was wound in my hair when I came to this place, and it grew strong amongst the stone, flourishing, flourishing, until it ran thick throughout the maze like the unraveling hair of a crone. And so this maze of another becomes my garden."
I had some other questions. "Why were you imprisoned, Revel?"
"I tried to help a lady, and kindly she did not take to it."
"The Lady of Pain? You tried to help her?"
"My offering of help was unwelcome. I tried to set her free," Sigil's the cage. "A city of doors and locks is a prison for her. It must be, mustn't it be? Why else call the city of Sigil the cage? And who is Cage? The lady. A prison too so small for one so great. Unjustness, wrongness, intolerable to torment a woman thusly."
"I think I know who should be in a cage."
"I try to break the cage, let the lady go free."
She makes a shooing motion, her expression becoming pained as she scatters invisible birds.
"Shoo, shoo, paint, oh paint woman, let Sigil's wing be broken so you might fly far from its filthy streets and the stupid Davos that dare not speak in words for fear their thoughts would be overheard."
Revel's hands slowly stop their shooing motion and she gives a slow sigh. Go on.
Before I could finish, I found myself here and my memories none the better for the trip. Much has slipped away, much forgotten, as it was. Is, was. Revel smiles with her yellow teeth. The dwindling of memory has become a comfort to these old bones. Much have I forgotten. I am fortunate in that I still remember you.
But why did you try to free the Lady of Pain from Sigil?
Updated my journal.
Revel's voice drops, almost reprimanding.
I resent anyone, even a power, being imprisoned and think that all, everyone, whether stones, shores, or quiet-bladed ladies, should be free. Some have said more fool, I. Why risk such a thing, they said.
I think you did the right thing trying to set her free.
Klingt nett.
Und wir wollen ja ein bisschen Honig ums Maul schmieren. Das haben wir die ganze Zeit schon gemacht.
Is that what you were trying to do when I met you so long ago? Were you trying to set me free?
Fragen wir das mal.
Quite possibly, quite. Life's change and fear of death may have gripped too tightly on the man I knew. You then,
Revel picks at one of her jagged grey hairs, wrapping it around her finger.
No liking for chains and cages does Revel have.
Yeah, so I was caged somehow, or chained. It sounds to me as if your memory is stirring, Revel.
Yes.
Revel blinks for a moment and her black-veined eyes become duller as if she has been struck with a heavy weapon. Her talon tightens around the grey hair so tightly it looks like she is about to tear it from her skull.
Mayhap, you were trapped, but it was no normal cage that held you.
Do you have any idea what held me?
Updated my journal.
Revel looks confused and her face twists as if she is fighting an unpleasant thought.
I have forgotten. May I have a promise?
No. Her finger tightens around the grey hair and to your surprise there's a snap like a twig breaking and Revel tears the hair from her head. A trickle of black blood worms from beneath her skull cap and she hisses in anger. Revel, are you all right?
No more, will I say.
Revel's face wrinkles in pain, the talon covered with the blood-tipped grey hair. Even plucked from her head, it looks jagged and stiff.
I do not know, and no knowing shall I share.
She stares down at the grey hair wrapped around her talon, and then she hisses and flicks it to you.
Take this and leave the past where it lies, half-man.
Very well, Revel, then there's nothing more to be said on the matter. I had some other questions. Ja, da haben wir aber noch die andere Möglichkeit. Mal gucken, ob wir da nochmal hinkommen. Die Dialogoption. Why were you imprisoned? Go on. Why? I think you did the right thing trying to set her free.
I'm glad that we share like mind and view like-minded on this matter. Yet, when I cannot let matters well enough alone, it seems to mine eyes that many are the lives and dreams that are left in pieces on the ground.
So you are at fault, Revel? At least you tried, where others would have lacked the courage. I see no fault in your intentions. In fact, I see only strength. Wieder ein bisschen schmierig, schmierig. Aber offensichtlich mögen Nighthags das. Revel stares at you in silence for a moment, then she cackles to herself. Such honeyed words! Ja, genau, das ist die Idee. How have I missed you, my precious half-man! You sing so sweetly, Stone would give up its blood for you. There's no harm in speaking the truth. I have other questions for you, Revel. Wahrscheinlich werden wir jetzt total chaotisch geworden sein, aber ich meine, die Lady befreien, bekloppt uns. Egal. The legends claim you are a powerful mage, Revel. Can you teach me some of the art? Revel frowns disapprovingly, her bluish skin twisting like a rag. Does Revel know the art? Is your mind gone away of the mortality? Think all up and lost? I have forgotten more of the art than you shall. She jabs you with one of her talents. Ever! She jabs you again. No! Also irgendwie ein bisschen drollig ist er ja schon, ne? Can you teach me some of the art then? Revel narrows her black-veined eyes studying you. Mayhap I could be persuaded by one such as you. Though any other would not have such a chance, nor the boon I offer. Are you a rudimentary student in the arts, or am I facing a tried master? Oh Gott, also diese Stimme ist nicht gut für meine Stimme. A master in the arts, beautiful Revel.
Flatterer, and yet your words warm me.
Your voice changes, alternating in pitch like someone plucking a stringed instrument.
Much have I learned tending this garden, charms and incantations distilled from the barbs.
She begins to hum slightly to herself.
Rhyming, swaying ways of the consonants, constants and motions that bring the briars to your aid. Listen, the branches will speak of it.
Close your eyes and listen. As you close your eyes and listen, a great trembling passes through you, as if dozens of barbed snakes were burrowing beneath your flesh. Just when you think the pain is more than you can bear, you suddenly instinctively begin humming the same tune that Revel did, and the pain ebbs. In the distance of the maze, you can hear the clicking of the tree creatures, as if responding to your call. Continue to hum. Revel watches you with a curious light in her black-veined eyes.
Such power!
She gives a soft hiss, as if in wonder, and her lips peel back in a smile.
It touches all that hear it. You are powerful, my precious man, so powerful. One day even the plains may bend to your will.
I do not wish such a thing, Revel. There are many who would walk that path, but not I. Revel nods, then nods at your hand, which to your surprise holds a number of black barbed seeds.
Take those seeds, use them as you will, and to this I grant an additional boon.
She plucks a hair from her head and takes a handful of the seeds, places them in her palm, then crushes them. A small trail of blackish blood runs from her hand, but when she opens it there is no wound, only a necklace of black barbs, woven around a lock of Revel's grey hair. So fantastic.
Take this, it is off me, and it will serve you well.
Take the seeds and the strange barbed charm.
Updated my journal.
Save those seeds, precious man. Use not all of them, for they may prove more useful in other places in this maze. But if powerful you are, these places you will find.
Very well. Mm-hmm. Thank you for the information you have given me, Revel. I must leave now. Hold. Revel's voice drops in a low hiss like that of a serpent.
The most important question you have yet to ask, my precious man. Has it occurred to you yet?
Yes, I need to know how to leave this place. Do you know the answer to this question?
I know the branching of this place, the twistings and bendings and burrowings. Though there are no leaves here, one take their leave when they wish it.
One may take their leave when they wish. So you do know how to leave.
Wrap your hands around. Wrap your hands about you like branches, make them encircle your chest like a cage. Step from the edge of the maze into the darkness and into another cage. Your body shall go, a simple leaving, but there's no return when that final step is taken. So take heed and take what you need before you take the step.
Which of the edges of the maze do I leave by?
Which, a question posed to the witch? Which? One of the edges knows, not I. The remembering of which has failed me, and the edges of the maze have had little to say on the matter.
You've known how to leave all this time. Then why don't you leave?
Why stay when one can leave, is your question to me?
Revel breaks into a crooked smile, displaying a row of fangs.
I turn the question upon its head and send it a scurrying back to you. The answer lies not in the staying or leaving, but in the causes and reasons, my precious half-man.
Don't you want to leave?
It is a want, a once want, but not a now want, and more not at want. What do I need that lies beyond my brambled walls? It is a cruel jagged world beyond the edges of this maze, and Revel has pulled enough of its shards from her skin.
You have done me a great service, beautiful Revel. Thank you for hearing my request and sharing your knowledge with me. Revel gives a crooked smile, all tusks, and then gives a soft cackle.
Ah, it is I who thanks you, my precious man. Long has it been since such sweet flattery has been brought to this maze. I wish to grant you boon, my songbird.
A boon. I would gladly accept any gifts you wish to give.
Then listen to me. Close your eyes and I shall let you see the nature of the multiverse.
Close your eyes and listen. Nice. Very nice. You close your eyes and as you do, you feel a sharp stabbing pain in your right eye. Your eye, one of your eyes, opens and you see Revel before you, her blood-red eyes gleaming with delight. One of her talons is extended and is tipped with your blood. And an eyeball. Yours.
What did you do? A boon I have granted, songbird, a twist of perception, a tap into the branches of the mind, a tap into the roots of Revel's knowing, have I granted you, a piece of me.
She takes the eyeball and you watch in disgust as she pulls forth a black seed and places them both in her left palm. With a grotesque smile she crushes the two of them with a sickening crunch.
Ah, give it back. Of course, precious man.
Revel opens her palm and your eye lies there, seemingly untouched, staring at you. She places it between her thumb and forefinger, then, before you can react, she steps it into your empty eye socket.
Updated my journal.
A piece of me lies in your good eye, precious man. When you see the planes through that eye, you will understand more than you once did. Wiser you will be, and more experience of the planes and their turnings will you understand. And that is all.
Very well, thank you, Revel. I must bid you farewell. As you are about to utter your farewell, you suddenly feel a crawling sensation in your skull, and you notice that Revel's black-veined eyes have been taken on a strange predatory fire. You're not going to let me leave, are you, Revel?
A perceptive question, yet it is not the real question.
Revel's voice takes on a strange whisper, very sad, that sends a faint echo through your mind. The question is, do you wish to leave me, half-man?
Fair Revel, you have helped me when I came to you so long ago, and you have done so again. I shall not forget what you have done, but now I must leave. I have to know more about myself.
There's a terrible shimmering in the air around Revel, and the sound of snapping twigs and cracking tree limbs, and the horrid sound of the trees bending and splintering.
What?
Revel's lips peel back, and her voice becomes shrill like a howling wind.
What do you know of knowing, half-man?
Know this. No, you will stay here until the end days in my brambled garden, never to leave, and you shall love me as you were meant, as you promised.
Oh God, oh God. Wir haben ja gesagt, oh God. Anfängerfehler, nameless one. I'm afraid I would be poor company, Revel. I cannot stay in any event. I'm afraid you must allow me passage.
I shall not let you leave. I have the power to keep you here, and I shall use it. My black barbed maze shall not allow you to travel beyond it while I live, my precious, precious man.
Revel, I don't want to fight you. Don't do this. Allow me passage, and I shall return to visit you. You need not be alone in this place.
Return? Return as you claimed you would so long ago? No, you shall not lie to Revel twice. No more centuries will I wait for you.
Revel's lips peel back, and her talons seem to grow into fiendish claws.
Here in my garden you will stay, and wander the plains you will no longer.
There's no need
you
for this.
You have forgotten your place, half-man. Humility is in order.
Revel, don't do this.
My journal. Checks.
Gut, stellen wir uns alle brav auf.
Attend me, my pets.
Gather to me.
Okay.
You have become strong.
Das ist richtig. Und deswegen bringen wir dich jetzt auch um. Ach, ich liebe diese unübersichtlichen Kämpfe, man sieht genau gar nichts. Ah, sie scheint tot zu sein. Oder sind wir tot? Ja, jetzt kommen auch noch Shadows, das ist ja fantastisch. Und irgendwelche anderen Untoten? Oh, das ist ja wunderbar. Ja, Spiel, ich hab's verstanden, es sind eine Menge. Okay. Okay. Das war das Ende von Revel. Da liegt sie. Oder war es das Ende? Immer drauf. Noch ein paar feindliche Triggits.
Playtime is over.
Aha. Oh. Greater Shadow klingt nicht gut. Greater Shadow ist tot. Okay, jetzt noch die Shadows. Come on. Bringt sie um.
Alright.
So, jetzt haben wir noch.
Alright.
Revels Belongings einsammeln. Blackbarb Necklace, Hardcharm. Okay. So, jetzt können wir speichern. Ja, da würde ich sagen, sehen wir uns beim nächsten Mal hier wieder, wenn wir versuchen, das Blackbarb Maze zu verlassen. Also, bis dahin. Tschüss.